Hey guys, my name is Priscilla Elias, and today I'll tell you what, in my opinion, is the most versatile lens of all. If you've already been doing some research on what's the best lens to buy that will be good for pretty much anything, you probably know by now that no matter what lens you get, will bring you pros and cons. I shoot Canon, and there's one lens that, in my opinion, can be used for pretty much any situation though, and that is the 24-70mm 2.8 aperture lens. If you're not a Canon shooter, it's okay. You can also find this lens for Nikon and Sony as well. But why? Why is this the most versatile lens of all? If you shoot portraits, since it's a zoom lens with a pretty decent aperture, you can both take full body shots as well as close-up shots. If you use it in 70mm, by the way, at 2.8 aperture, you will get some awesome bokeh in the background. Is it the same as having an 85mm and shoot it at f1.4? Of course not. We're talking about a prime 1.4 aperture lens versus a 2.8 aperture lens. But I've done portraits with this lens and it does an amazing job. If you want to see a comparison of a portrait taken with this lens and with other lenses, I'll leave a link for a video I recently recorded with that test up here and also down in the description. If you shoot product photography, it's an amazing lens as well. In fact, I did an entire tutorial where I teach product photography made at home, and I used this 24-70mm for my shot. It's a very sharp lens and it will deliver you very high quality images. You can check that video where I shoot product photography with my 24-70 in the link you will find up here and in the description as well. If you shoot very small items such as rings and stuff like that, it might not be the best lens of all though. In that case, maybe you should get a macro lens instead. I myself have the Canon 100mm 2.8 for those types of shots. But if you're not shooting such specific items, again, the 24-70 can do an amazing job. If you want to do street photography, again, this lens can do the job. If you shoot it at 24mm, you will get a pretty wide focal length and it will allow you to have a lot in your photo. If you want to catch something or someone who's further away from you, then the 70mm will get you pretty close in most situations. Of course, if you want to shoot something that's really, really far from you and you want to get a close-up for that, maybe then you should have a 70-200mm f2.8. But hey, we're talking about a much heavier and bigger lens. Plus, if you want wider shots, the 70-200mm won't help you at all. If you do documentary photography or weddings, then more than in the other cases, hands down, this would be the lens I'd have with me all the time. It will give you a very nice range of different focal lengths to work in different situations. In fact, I can do an entire wedding with only this lens and not miss pretty much anything. For the weddings I shoot, I usually use this lens for about 85, maybe 90% of the day. And okay, now you might be wondering, if this lens is so good and so versatile, why doesn't everybody get this lens first? First, because it's a pretty expensive piece of glass for most photographers who are just starting out. Usually when you're starting out, you're trying out new things, you're learning, and you don't want to spend a whole bunch of money on equipment. For that reason, this wouldn't even be the first lens I would recommend for someone who is just starting out and has never been in touch with photography before. Not because it's not good enough, but just because it's very expensive. And if you would like to know what lens I recommend for anyone starting out, I'll leave a link for the video I did talking specifically about that up here and in the description as well. Now, if you're starting out and you don't mind spending more money though, it's a pretty nice lens to have as a starter. You will get pretty much all covered with it. You'll find this lens for about $1,700, and this is the main downside to it. The second downside to the 24-70mm lens would be its weight. It is not the smallest nor the lightest lens of all. It weighs 805 grams, and if you need to shoot with it all day long, it might get you a little tired after a couple of hours. Nice! This is a very versatile lens. Now, if I get this lens, is this all I need? Well, then we get back to the initial discussion. If you've been doing some research on lenses, you know by now there's no such thing as the best lens of all. If such a thing existed, everybody would only get that one lens and done. Meaning, if you get this lens and you keep doing photography, at some point you will realize you could do different things with different specific results if you had a different or different lenses. Maybe you will want more depth of field, so you want a prime lens. Maybe you will want a lighter lens. Maybe you will want a lens with even a wider focal length. Then you could get a 16 to 35 millimeter. Or you want to do close-ups and have a macro lens for details and then have a 100 millimeter macro. Or you want to take photos of birds and trees and wild animals in nature and stuff like that and have a telephoto lens, so you'd go for a 70 to 200 millimeter lens. The point is, if you like photography, believe me, you won't stop on your first lens. But if you want a very versatile lens, the 24 to 70 would be definitely my one to go. As I said, when I shoot weddings, I pretty much only use this lens, and during the wedding day, I get a great variety of situations. Portraits, churches and whole big venues, close-ups of people, the party itself. If I only have the 24 to 70 with me and an external flash, I'm good to go. It will do the job just fine. If I travel and I want to take photos from the place I'm visiting, just the same, I will be able to get wider shots of buildings, mountains, churches, and also get very nice portraits with blurry backgrounds as well. It'll do the job just fine. So if you have the money and you want to invest in some good glass, the 24 to 70 millimeter is a must-have lens to your collection. I strongly recommend it, as it is nowadays one of the lenses I most use for my kit. If you want to check the 24 to 70 lens out, you will find a link for it in the description as well, for the Canon, the Nikon, and the Sony. And this is it, guys. I hope this video helps you to understand how versatile the 24 to 70 millimeter lens is, and I hope it helped you to figure out if this is a lens for you or not. I would also kindly ask you that if you like this video, you will hit the like button, subscribe to this channel, and click the little bell down here so you will be notified when I come up with new content. Please let me know your thoughts down below, and let me know if there's anything else you would like to know about this lens or any other lens specifically. I will be very glad to help you. I will see you in the next video. Ciao!